Question number 14. Sides AB and AC and medians AD of a triangle ABC are respectively proportional to sides PQ and PR and median PM of another triangle PQR show that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Solution. Figure they have not given. We have to draw. Okay. You should have sufficient place below these diagrams because you have to do some construction here. Say this is triangle ABC and this is triangle PQR. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, given, write small g here. Given AB proportional to PQ and AC proportional to PR. So you can write AB by PQ equal to AC by PR. AC by PR. And also they have mentioned medians. AD. AD means from A here to start. And that median should bisect BC into equal parts. That means these two are now equal. AD is proportional to what? PM. And now these two are also equal parts. These two are also equal parts. Whatever BC is there, half of that is BD, half of that is DC. Whatever QR is there, half of it is QM and half of it is MR. So right here, AD upon PM. This is also given. Now, I have to prove triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. To prove that, AB by PQ should be equal to BC by QR should be equal to AC by PR. We are given only two corresponding side ratios equal, but about third they have not mentioned. Third one we have to prove now, and then we can say the two given triangles are similar triangles. But instead of giving third ratio equal to these two ratios, they have given median or proportional. The corresponding medians of two triangles are proportional. We have to make use of that. Now you write. We call this as one here only. Extend AD to E such that AD equal to DE. Extent PM to N such that PM equal to MN. PM equal to MN. That means you have to extend it like this. And here also you extend it like this. Let there be some proportionality. Here I have taken two lines for AD. Here I will take two lines for DE. Then join E to B and E to C. Join E to B and E to C. N. PM is extended to N such that PM is equal to MN. Right? Now join N to R and N to Q. Right here, join N to Q and N to R. N to R. AD is equal to D by construction here. Similarly, PM equal to MN by construction. That means what is D here? D is point of intersection of two diagonals AE and BC of quadrilateral ABEC. Similarly, M is point of intersection of diagonals of quadrilateral PQNR. And here you can observe BC and AE are bisecting each other, and in quadrilateral PQNR, diagonal PN and QR are bisecting each other. Diagonals bisect each other in which quadrilateral, you recall? Rhombus. Next. Anyone? Diagonals bisect in which quadrilateral? Parallelogram. Very good. Rhombus is correct, but in a rhombus, diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. Here we don't have knowledge of these angles. How much are these angles? We don't know. So we cannot call it as rhombus. But in a parallelogram, diagonals bisect each other. Therefore, I can take A, B, E, C and P, Q and R as two parallelograms right now. In quadrilateral, ABEC and PQNR the diagonals are bisecting each other at D and M respectively. respectively. Therefore, these two quadrilaterals are parallelograms. They are not parallelograms. In parallelograms, opposite sides are equal. That is, AB must be equal to EC. And B must be equal to AC. PQ must be equal to NR and QN must be equal to PR. Is it right? All right, that. AB equal to EC and B equal to AC. B equal to AC. In parallelogram ABEC and PQ equal to NR and QN equal to PR, in parallelogram PQ NR. PQ NR. Is it okay? Welcome to figures. AB equal to EC, I will have some mark here, I will write V on it. Here also I will write V, opposite sides. And here B equal to AC, I will write on this W. And here I will write W. Okay. Next. Similarly here in quadrilateral PQNR. I will write here Z. PQ must be equal to NR. So here also I will write Z. Some no. Symbol you have to have there to show equality. Very unusual symbols I am using here. Right? And here I will use I. I will use here I. Right here, multiply. multiply AD by PM in 1 by 2 by 2 by 2 by 2. AB by PQ equal to AC by PR equal to AD by PM into 2 by 2. What do you get? You get AB by PQ equal to AC by PR equal to what is 2 times AD and what is 2 times PM. Go back to figure. This is AD, this is also equal to AD. So 2 times AD means AE you will get. Here you are having PM and PM is equal to MN, that means 2 times PM you are having. 2 times PM is nothing but PN. Okay. So 2 times AD is AE and 2 times PM is PN. Like that. AE by PN. Okay. What we'll do is these two together we will call as 2. These two together we will call as 2. And this one we will call as 3. This one we will call as 3. From two and three, from two and three, in place of AB, I will write EC from two. In place of PQ, I will write NR. Equal to AC by PR equal to AE by PN. AE by PN. For your reference, you can have two triangles like this. AEC PN R. What we wrote? AE by PN equal to AC by PR equal to EC by NR. Therefore, triangle AEC is similar to triangle PNR. By which rule? By SSS similarity criterion. Similarity criterion. Therefore, angle EAC will be equal to angle NPR. You call it as four now. You call it as four. Now what we have to prove? We have to prove triangle ABE is similar to triangle PQN, but we will not write it completely. We will use word similarly. That is very powerful word. It can reduce your pages of work. Similarly is very, very, very powerful word. Similarly, triangle AE B is similar to triangle PNQ. By SSS similarity criterion. Therefore, angle EAB is equal to angle NPQ. Why we are writing like this? By CPST. Here also by CPST. Adding 4 and 5, angle EAC plus angle EAB equal to angle NPR plus NPQ. What is EAC plus EAB? It will become angle A. NPR plus NPQ will become angle P. You can see here. EAC plus EAD. That means these two angles we are adding. It will become total angle A. And here we are adding angle NPR and NPQ. So total angle P will be obtained. So written angle A equal to angle P. Call it as 6. From 1, we can write AB by PQ equal to AC by PR. We call it as 7. From 6 and 7, triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. By SAS, similarity criterion. By SAS, similarity criterion.